Question is from Just Another Mike. What are your thoughts on the carnivore diet, and how long should you run it?
I think if you...
You're not just another Mike.
If you like ice cream and cake and popcorn and tortilla chips, it's a fucking terrible diet. I mean, if you like any of those things or want any of those things...
Or fruits and vegetables and nuts and anything else that's not meat.
I mean, I think it's terrible.
It's pretty limiting, yeah.
Do I think the science to support the health benefits of all of it? Like, yeah, there's a select group of people that are going to do really, really well. Actually, there's probably a big majority of people, if they switched from the American diet and they went to carnivore, they'd see all kinds of health markers improve. And if you're a carnivore advocate that's going around talking about how great it all is, these are the things you're sharing. You're talking about what happens when you take somebody who is on all these foods and then you put them on a car, all these markers.
Well, if you have autoimmune issues, you have like SIBO, you have all these different like underlying issues, and you're limiting it down to one nutrient source that's, you know, but, like, pretty manageable.
Right. So it's incredible for that.
Yeah,
but
it seems, yeah.
I mean, I remember when I was on the ketogenic diet and I fucking wanted to shoot myself.
Yeah.
I mean, I can only eat so many macadamia nuts and olive oil,
butter, and
it's like
ghee. You're like, what am I supposed to do?
You know, it's a lot of fun at first, just like I think if I were to do the carnivore diet, like
steak,
I love
steak 4 times a day.
I love
steak. I love burgers.
Yeah, I love ribeye and
try
to.
Much?
Yeah, but at one point, you know, I want a little balance. So, you know, that's how I feel about the any. And here's the thing too.
This is not just for this diet. It's for all diets.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
exactly.
And people need to understand that, like, the whole diet world is just. It's designed to divide and conquer all of you that are, you know, it's like,
wow. Yeah. Like, I don't understand why they're so adamant about like having everybody conform to one specific thing. It doesn't work like that.
Well, the carnivore diet has all the makings of a successful marketing wise and fad wise type of diet. It's got all the wonderful
extreme.
It eliminates the one food everybody told you was super healthy, or the two foods, right? Fruits and vegetables, huh? You got my attention now.
Yeah, I always hated vegetables. This sounds interesting.
It's low calorie. All diets that make you lose weight are low calorie. I don't care what kind of diet you follow. And why is a carnivore low diet? You've just eliminated almost all food. And eating only one thing, you're probably not going to eat that much. I don't care what that one thing.
It's going to be really hard to get calories. That's 100% like what I experienced like going through it too.
Yes.
And it's the thing is, like, you just get like full, you get satiated, so you get like all of that going for you. But it's at the end of the day, like, man, it was a real big challenge to just meet my caloric needs.
It's also basic and simple. And if for a diet to become successful marketing wise, it has to be clear and simple. Don't eat carbs. Don't eat fat. Don't eat vegetables. Don't eat meat. Whatever. It's people like that. It's very catchy. Like, oh, I can do that. I can just eat meat or just eat, you know, no carbs or whatever. It's got all the makings of something that could be successful marketing wise. Now, in terms of, is it a good diet for people? So there's two things I want to say about that. One, there is no perfect diet for everybody. None. I don't care who you are. First off, there are going to be some people that are going to do well on a carnivore diet. My guess is the vast majority of them have lots of immune reactions to other foods.
Mm-hmm.
They have lots of food intolerances, and carnivore diet's the ultimate elimination diet where you eliminate most foods that people might have reactions to. So that's the big thing about this particular diet is that some people have a lot of food intolerances. They eliminate that. You know, like Michaela Peterson, great example. She had some legit immune issues, and eliminating all those foods made her feel really good. And for her, I have no doubt that this is the best diet, but for most people it isn't. The second thing is this, just because you can do something doesn't mean you should, because I think there's a lot of people that are like, wow, I only ate meat for a month and I didn't die. And they think, oh, that means it's a good thing. No, not necessarily. I mean, you could eat the typical American diet for, you know, 60 years and not die either. That doesn't mean it's ideal as well. It's very extreme. There's lots of value to consuming a variety of foods. Vegetables and fruits and nuts and even grains have their own values.
And some of the values that I think are important that when you eliminate them in a diet like this is the ones that we talk about that aren't just nutritional value. It's not always just about that. Sometimes, mm-hmm. like, you know, try being the guy who has to tote around, you know, a tri-tip everywhere you go and you're at a birthday party or right. you're at a, you know, a dinner party or you're going over for somebody's having wine and cheese event.
Yeah, now you're like, a social leopard.
Right. So, and if those things are important and you like to do that stuff, I think that eliminating that, it becomes really challenging. And so personally, and we've done it, aesthetically, I've been able to keep myself in good shape running all types of different diets. Now, I haven't done a pure carnivore, although I've ran keto, which is close. It's just even less stuff, right? And it kept myself in great shape. So if it's just about getting shape, you could do anything. You could do vegan, you could do keto, you could do zone, they all work and have success with people. Yeah. And they're,
and you have a lot of people who are navigating the diet world and they want to lose weight or whatever. And it's like, oh my gosh, everything's so complicated. What do I do? Do I count macros? Do I count calories?
Yeah, this is the least complicated out of all of them.
Yeah, it's like, hey, dude, just eat meat. You'll lose weight. Yeah. If you just eat meat, and it's like, I can do that.
Yeah.
I could totally do that.
I think that's where the appeal of it is, though, I'll be honest, like even for myself. But, you know, like I know there's a short window to it. And like, again, looking at it from an elimination perspective, I think like there's some value to that. But other than that, the other value is that there's a counter to veganism. So I appreciate that from an entertainment value.
Yeah.
That's really the only thing I can think of.
It's so funny because they're in the same, without realizing it, they're on the same.
They're like at war.
They're in the same camp, though.
They're the same. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They're so extreme.
Oh, yeah. No, 100%.
They're both extreme.